Hi, I'm Nick from Australian Native Bee, and today I would like to share with you a method I've been using for a long time to help clean out my hives if a hive or colony of native bees happens to come under attack by pests. I hope you enjoy. Basically, what happened here, just to explain how the pests got in the hive. Yes, I do have pest problems sometimes. This log hive here was actually sitting over here where these hives are now, and it came under attack by a swarm. So I put three hives, which were pretty much empty, in place of the log. I actually turned this log around, put a towel over it, so these hives became the focus. There were some bees in these hives because I had them connected to other hives and things like that. And what I was hoping for is that a swarm would move into these. So I swapped these around. Also, this box was included, but they, for whatever reason, chose this hive, so swarms actually moved into there. At the time swarms attack native bees, the bees release stress pheromones, and the stress pheromones attract pests. So you can see, I don't know, now and again you'll see a fly, just a normal sort of a house fly. But at the time this was happening, this hive, that hive, and this hive had forage fly all attacked them. This hive here had quite a good colony in it, and I didn't want to lose it, so I moved it to another area in the yard. But the forage fly had moved in, and it was too late. Now, if you've never seen how bad forage fly can get ready to be disgusted. Now, most people, when they see something like this, these are native hive beetle here too, they move in, but these larvae here are forage fly, and they're disgusting. If you've never seen a full healthy colony be overcome by a fly, it can be quite a shock. They release a bit of a toxic, exude a toxic sort of stink, and that actually kills bees. Now, most people would burn this hive or something, but there is a way to fix it, and I'm going to show you today. So we're over here, I'm using a log colony, and what I'm going to do is use the worker bees of the log colony and connect it, as crazy as it sounds, to this box. And those bees are going to be so upset by the smell of those maggots that they will come out and begin to grab the maggots and clean them out of the hive. Now, in terms of maggots spreading from this back into the log colony or box colony that you use for this method, it just simply doesn't happen. If the bees feel like they can't handle it, they'll actually seal it off here and protect their colony. But so far, I haven't had them do that. So all I'm doing is putting this tube. Now, I did have a colony that was probably not quite so bad as this. Have it happen before, and I actually hooked two colonies of bees into the box because I was interested to see whether two separate colonies would actually fight or they would work together. And what was really interesting is both colonies came in. The bees did not latch on or fight like they normally would if you connected two colonies together. They actually got together and worked to clean out the box. So over the next few weeks, I will show you what happens in the box. And you can see the slow process of the bees cleaning out the hive. That's it. Alrighty, we're back here about 3 weeks later. Sorry, I didn't make a movie in between to show you what happened. This particular infestation was so bad, the worst I've seen, that I actually had to swap logs to a stronger colony to help clear them out, and I actually removed some structure as well that was infested. So I'll just show you what's happening inside the box now. As you can see, the bees have removed all the pest maggots and they're just working on the structure now. You can see that sort of sawdusty appearance on the wax there. Some people say that's mites. You also see that too when hive beetle have been present in a native beehive. So same thing, I basically moved the entrance which was stuck to the log back there. See the bees going in and out, and some of the structure I moved, I placed here, and you can see that the ants have actually come and grabbed all those maggots. They've actually moved their ants nest here. So basically, yeah, from here on the bees are just going to build in there and eventually make a new colony. That's it. I hope this tutorial will help somebody fix their native beehive when it comes under attack from pests. Thank you.